Bees are our most important crop pollinators, but there's a problem. Some bees are in trouble, and so are the food crops they pollinate. Honeybees continue to struggle from challenges including poor nutrition, disease, mites and other hive pests, and pesticide exposure. Some wild bees are also in trouble. Wild bee populations may be declining in many of the same regions where the acreage of crops that need pollination is increasing. If this trend continues, these crops may completely lose the pollination that wild bees provide. So what can we do to support bees and improve pollination? There's a growing consensus that adding flowering plants to farm landscapes helps pollinators. Wildflower plantings provide safe places to nest and flowers where bees can collect pollen and nectar. Pollen provides protein, fats, and nutrients. It's the meat and vegetables in a bee's diet. Nectar provides carbohydrates or sugars that fuel bee flight. Natural areas rich with flowers were once scattered in and around farm fields. Many of these areas have been plowed under to make way for larger fields and more crop production, or paved over for urban development. In the U.S., more than 290 million acres of grassland have been converted to agriculture or urban development. These grasslands were the diverse, flower-rich habitats in which bees thrived. So in today's world, what's a farmer to do if she wants to support wild bees and the pollination they provide? Is the solution as simple as bringing more flowers into farms? A number of farmers and scientists are testing this idea for blueberry, almond, cherry, and watermelon crops as part of the Integrated Crop Pollination Project. Results from Michigan blueberry farms are promising. Researchers planted wildflower meadows filled with native prairie plants next to blueberry fields. They counted bees in the plantings and nearby crop fields and compared these numbers against field edges that didn't have wildflower plantings. As the meadows matured, bee abundance and diversity increased, and so did wild bee visits to the blueberry flowers next to the planting. Yields were 10 to 15% higher in fields next to meadows than in those that didn't have flowers nearby. The returns farmers got from increased yields meant that these plantings more than paid for themselves after only 4 years. Around the world, study after study has found that when you add wildflowers to farms, whether in the form of wildflower strips, meadows, or hedgerows, you get more bees. The bees these plantings support tend to be the most important agricultural pollinators, helping to increase pollination and yield of nearby crops. It's time to take action to counter the loss of bee habitat across the country. Just as habitat starts with a single flower, this change can start with you. To learn more about planting wildflowers for bees and other ways to support crop pollinators, visit our website at www.projecticp.org.